create brush stroke text effect, we are going to use mainly one tool, which is nothing but mixer brush tool, this one. Fine, let's see how to use the tool. First, go to the project file, open the PSD file inside Photoshop. This one is a design ready file. If you want, you can create your own canvas with any size, it's not going to be an issue. Let's start by creating a solid color background. Go to the background group, create a layer. Now go to color picker, select any color you want, fill the color. I use a keyboard shortcut Alt Backspace. Fine, next we're going to type in our text. Go to the text group, create a layer. Now go to color picker, pick black color. The font I'm using is a free font. I'll give a link in the description. You can download it if you want. With size as 1000, I'll type in my text. Make sure to have enough space between the alphabets so that we will get the realistic brushstroke text effect. If you want, you can use any other font, but make sure the font styling looks like a paint brush strokes. Fine, next we're going to drop in an image. For that, go to the project file, open image one inside Photoshop. Now drag and drop the image inside our canvas. Of course, if you want, you can use any other images like Nebula, Galaxy wallpaper. All you need is a colorful image here. Fine, now drag and drop the image. Next, we are going to reduce the opacity of the image down to 30% so that our text layer will be visible. Now enable free transform tool, Ctrl T, and resize it. If you want, you can add a little bit of rotation. I want blue and pink color for the alphabet P. Fine, that's why I'm placing the image like so. Once you're done, click enter. Next, I'm going to repeat the same process for the rest of the alphabets. I create a duplicate copy using keyboard shortcut Ctrl J. Now move the image to right side, resize the image, give a little bit of rotation so that we'll get different kind of colors for each alphabet. I'm going to repeat the same step for the rest of the alphabet. Create a duplicate copy, Ctrl J, place it right above the alphabet, give a little bit of rotation. If you want, you can resize the image. Fine, once you're done, now by holding Ctrl key in your keyboard, select all the four layers and increase the opacity to 100%. There you go, now our image is ready. Next, we're going to install a brush. For that, go to the project file and double click and install the paint stroke brush. Next, by holding Ctrl key in your keyboard, select all the four image layers. Now merge them into a single layer by using keyboard shortcut Ctrl E. Fine. Next, create a layer. Now here comes the main trick. Now pick the brush tool. There, select the mixer brush tool. Now select the newly installed brush. Actually, this round bristle brush is by default available in Photoshop, but you may be using different version of Photoshop. I don't want to confuse you. That's why I've given you the brush file. Now make sure you enable the clean each brush stroke option. Keep the wet as 100 and other settings as 100. Smoothing option also 100. Make sure sample all layer option is enabled. Fine. Now comes the interesting part. Next, disable the text layer. Now hold Ctrl key in your keyboard and click the layer thumbnail. There you go, we got our text selection. Next, select the new layer. Next, we're going to add brush strokes. For this alphabet, I'm going to add two strokes, one from the right to left and another one from bottom to top. Make sure to add strokes in a single direction like so. Here I'm going to include dark color. For that, I'm going to add strokes by including those dark color and pulling it a little bit up. Continue adding strokes until you cover the entire selection. Make sure to give few extra clicks on edges. As I said before, the image we are using plays a key role here, so you can experiment with any colorful image you want. Once you're done, zoom out and disable the image layer. Now you can see the output. If you want, you can make corrections, add little more strokes. Fine, now enable the image. Now we are going to continue the same step for rest of the alphabets. If you want, you can use a different image for each alphabet. Now I'll fast forward the process. Once you are done, hit Ctrl D to deselect. Now disable the image layer. There you go, we got our effect. If you zoom in, you can see the alphabet edges looks crystal clear. It doesn't give that authentic brushstroke feel. We're going to take care of that now. we're going to use the same mixer brush tool, but we're going to tweak the settings a little bit. Now again, pick the mixer brush tool. Now reduce the width to 30%. Now decrease the smoothing to 20%, and make sure to disable the sample all layers. By doing so, our background image will not be included while adding the strokes. Fine. Now zoom in and start adding 2 to 3 strokes on it just to create that realistic brushstroke feel. I'm going to apply one here, another one here, another one here. Now you might have noticed that alphabet edges looks crystal clear. Okay, we don't want that. We want that authentic feel. So that I'm going to give few random clicks here and there. Make sure to keep the brush strokes minimal. And yes, I'm going to apply the same step for rest of the alphabets. I'll fast forward the process. Once we're done, next we're going to add shadows to our text. Actually, this step is totally optional. You can skip it if you don't want. If you want, all you got to do is create a layer. Now go to color picker, select black color. Now pick the pen tool. If you don't know how to use pen tool means, I'll tell you a simple trick. We're going to use pen tool to create selection. Make sure the path is selected. You don't need to touch other settings. Now zoom in. Using pen tool, we are going to create a selection where we are going to add black color to create shadow. First, give a single click here. Second click goes here. Now we created a straight line path. Now give a third click on center. Now hold control key. Now you can convert the straight line path into a curve like so. I'm going to use the very same technique. Fourth click goes here. Fifth click on center. Now hold control key. Make it as curved one. Now 6th click close here. 7th click on center, hold control key and convert it as a curved path. Now close the selection like so. Now right click, pick the make selection option. Make sure feather is 0, anti-alias is enabled. Now click OK. Now we are going to add black color. For that, pick the brush tool. Now pick the soft round brush. Now make sure flow and opacity is 100. Now give few clicks like so to add shadow kind of effect. There you go. Now you can deselect it by using keyboard shortcut Ctrl D. By using the very same technique, we're going to add shadows to all of our alphabets. Pick the brush tool. Make a selection like so. Once you completed the path, right click, make selection, make sure feather is 0, click OK. Now pick the brush tool. I used keyboard shortcut B to select the brush. Now add black color. There you go, we got our realistic shadow effect. I'm going to apply the very same effect to rest of the alphabets using the pen tool technique. I'll fast forward the process. Once you're done, now merge all our layers into a single layer by using keyboard shortcut Ctrl Alt Shift E. Now go to filter, select camera raw filter. There I'm going to increase the vibrance and saturation a little bit so that our image will look a little bit vibrant and colorful. Next in the preset, I'm going to select sharpening. There I'll select heavy so that our brush strokes will look a little more sharper and realistic. Next in creative, you can select any option you want. This step is optional. There I'm going to select Turkish red, this one. Click OK. It's up to you. You can go with any settings here. I'll go with Turkish blue. Now click OK. There you go. We got realistic paintbrush stroke text effect in Photoshop.